You are looking at the desk. Someone who is in prime prep mode. It's going. I've got so much left to do before I leave tomorrow and more to do at the hotel. But that's how conventions go. Whether you're doing a cosplay or you're working an artist alley table or whatever it is, there's always sleepless nights leading up to that Friday.
ああ、素晴らしき世界に今日も乾杯。街に飛び交う笑い。声も見て見ぬふりしてるだけの作りもさ。気が触れそうだ。
So, I've done a lot of MAGFests. And usually I'm in a two queen situation because I'm sharing with someone. And this time I have a one king bed. This is awesome. Look at all this space. But yeah, this is awesome. We're also like super close to the ground, like fourth floor and right by the elevator. Usually I have quite the hike, but not this time. And right there, right out there is the main streetway. So this is super awesome. This is just so nice. Lots of space to spread out, which is great because we're here for the next four nights. And it's gonna be awesome. Tomorrow is set up and then after that it's selling time. But for now, I'm going to get to work sewing a bunch of stuff because I have a lot of work to do.
Doing two flights, lugging all the suitcases. My arms are so sore.
And we have arrived at setup. Here's the tables I have to work with, all my goodies. And my husband is getting another round of things. So here's hoping setup goes good. They gave us a cute little grab bag full of little candies. Very sweet of them. This is the first time I'm using this. I got this just like a few weeks for the con. I decided to get one of these. It's not straight right now, but yeah, it's a table banner. It was something I've been wanting to do because my current one doesn't show my website or anything. It's just that. You've seen it before. That was supposed to be a temporary one. Well, I got a better one designed because of COVID. You know, that never happened. So I finally got it done and it looks amazing. I can't wait to see what it looks like when everything's all set up. Here is the abomination pit. I'm trying something crazy, but I'm hoping it's gonna work. Behold the glory of my idea. It is the Furby pit. It's like they're in a little playpen waiting to be adopted. They're so glorious. Trying something new for the stickers and keychains. Price time will go here, and here's hoping that this works out and looks good. I want to try something different than the tower that I usually have. All right, so we finished this table as much as we can for right now. Definitely got prices and a few more things in the room to bring down. But it's looking good. Time for the other side now. And for now, we are done. We still have a few things left to make up in the room. So if you see spaces, that's why. And I also haven't put prices up yet. We have this so far. I won't go into it now since I'm going to go more tomorrow. My boys. And then some goodies I've started doing over here. So yeah, we're good for now. And tomorrow, it's the big day. Can't wait. And Mindy is excited to be at her first convention. And we are all tablecloth up for the night. Everything is covered. And yeah, time to go back to the room to get some sewing done and grab some grub tonight. Mindy's gonna come on adventures with us. And here is the line for attendees. It is happening. And it's only Thursday. Waking up to do more sewing. I'm really curious what this booth has. It's like the coolest setup ever. And for now, setup is done. I might fix some things later on in the day, but this is what we have for now. I'm very excited about it. This is the plushies, the buttons, and I'm trying a lot of new things this time. For example, I'm using my pink cubes that I usually use for pony conventions and ones that I fly to. instead of just the wire cubes. Just to give things a little more color, help the plush stand out a little bit. And I'm also trying this with the stickers and the pins, having it laying like that, because usually it's in a tower and it takes up so much space on the table and can be a little harder to shop. So I'm hoping that will make it a little easier. And then we have, of course, the mystery bags, my big boys. There's the glips. And then this is something I'm also trying different, is this long Furby pin. It's there's a little table right there, because you can see there how there's like a corner. So I put a little table here, and then the feet made up the difference to make it nice and sturdy. You can like knock on it, it's not going anywhere. Plus it's also zip tied. But yeah, I have the long Furby pin. I'm also trying raising their prices. I raised a few of my prices because I do kind of undercharge myself. It's a bad habit. So trying to raise my prices just a little bit and try and see how that goes. I can always go down later. But yeah, this is my Furby pin, and they're all very contained. They look very nice. I didn't put anything above them. They are the stars. You can see all the different colors. Pick out whichever one you want. Hope that might make it a little more shoppable. And then because it's a corner, I have this side too, where I've got the keychains, more keychains, buttons, mystery bags, plush, and midi up there. I also drew a little pot midi. So I'm hoping this works out. Also, I had a little space right there, so I put axolotls and other glep. So yeah, I think it's gonna work out. It looks really nice. It looks a lot nicer than I had thought it would. I actually got really anxious because I wasn't sure how this setup would look, because I just had some like loose plans, and so I'm glad it really came together, especially since I'm trying so many new things. And like I said, this is brand new for the table. That way it has my website on it and something people can just take a picture of real quick if I'm out of business cards. So I thought that might be a good thing to have, and especially since my old tablecloth is just this, it's hard to tell what my business name is and everything. So this was something I'd been meaning to upgrade for a while, but COVID kind of delayed me on that. But glad it's here now. It looks fantastic. Everything came out really good in this corner. And I hope I get more corners in the future, so that way I can make like nice big display. We'll see how that goes. I'm still perfectly fine with a 6 foot. And also MAGFest tables are super wide, so I was able to do a lot more things that I wouldn't normally be able to. So here's hoping we learn a lot, and that will go forward with future cons, and we can use what we learn here for that. Gosh, that was a shot to your drop day. That's all the fandom keychains I have left. Sold on a mouth mint, but I have more to make back in the room. The long Furbies are looking scarce over here. Not very many boys left. And then over here, sold a decent amount of this stuff. I only have one Emil left. Those are all the Appletons. And then all my bats, I sold a lot of the bats. So here's going for tomorrow.
Somehow these Furbies ended up organized by color. I didn't even do that. It's making me laugh.
Sewing done at the table, because usually when, you know, I'm not helping anyone, I'm sewing, because it kind of helps people to see, like, I do make the stuff and share with them the process. And it's also kind of interesting to see artists doing art at the table versus, like, being on their phones. So this is what I usually do, but there was no downtime. I got a few gimme goals sewn, just because you can do that pretty quick the way that I make them. So I finished all of those, but I still have a ton of other plush to make. So I'm not sure how the crowds will be on a Saturday. I'm not sure if this is one of those cons where everyone does shopping on Friday or not, but will be interesting to see. But yeah, it was insanely busy. So I'm sorry for the lack of, like, footage of people walking by the table and everything. I usually like to take some of that to kind of give people an idea of what to expect with convention crowds, and also to kind of show different costumes off and everything. And it's just fun to see, like, everyone walking by. KatsuCon is, like, a huge cosplay convention, so there's a ton of costumes everywhere, and all of them are really well done. It's just awesome. All right, we're all uncovered for day two. I have tried to fill things out a bit, so that way it doesn't look empty, and I think we were pretty successful with that. Everything's looking pretty good. I have more things to make in the back. Here's some Furbies. I made a fresh Glep, and I'm about to finish the last one that I brought, because I brought five and I had three made, and then I brought three to make because I wasn't sure how popular they'd be, and they were very popular. So made another Glep, going to make one more. Then here's all this stuff, all the bats. Everything's looking really good. I'm excited for day two.
初めてのルーブルはなんてことはなかったわ私だけのモナリザもうとっくに出会ってたかった初めてあなたを見たあの日動き出した車止められない喪失のようかんもういっぱいあるけどもう一つ増やしましょう でもそんなものはいらないわ。あなたが焼き付いたまま、私の心のプロジェクター、寂しくないふりしてた。まあそんなのお互い様が誰かを求めることは、すなわち傷つくことだった。
Annabelle cosplayer gave me a little butterfly. Super cute. Day. I'm going to go grab some breakfast and get my booth all set up. It's pretty quiet right now, which is kind of nice if you're trying to like get to places in a hurry, which I'm trying to hurry up and get breakfast and get everything situated at my booth before the big crowds come. I don't imagine it'll be too super busy. A lot of people partied hard last night, so they're sleeping it off, and we'll probably have a surge, I'm guessing, towards the end of the day. But then again, KatsuCon has surpassed any expectations I had, so who knows what to expect. But whatever happens, it's going to be fun. Alright, this is what the table looks like on the final day. We are pretty empty. I have a few things I'm going to be sewing throughout the day. I underestimated how busy it would be, so I didn't finish a lot of what I had brought to just like work on at the table. And that's where the sprigatito came from. I made that and that one last night. So we have some back keychains. I have a big mystery bag. They gave us a bag to use to put my water in at the marketplace. And I'm like, oh, mystery bag. So that's why that's there. I have a few keychains I need to refill before we open. Buttons are bare. Stickers. The long Furby's all sold, so this has turned into just a giant axolotl pit. People love it though. They love seeing all the axolotls in the pit. More very low buttons. More pegs I need to refill. And then these guys. Oh, and also on this bottom shelf here, I expanded the mystery bags out just so there's something there. And then once that sells, I'll take that shelf off. It's looking good, and here's hoping today goes awesome and I go home way lighter than I arrived.
Katsucon has officially closed. This is what we have left. 3 Chainsaw Man buttons. And my hero's looking scarce too. 3 bets. These guys. And I only have 1 of the hammerhead sharks left. He's over there. Sticklers. The pit has been refilled several times and it's still looking low. The last hammerhead. Low on all of these buttons. But Demon Slayer and Yasha is popular too. And we sold our mystery bags too. And all of our fandom keychains. And all the jellyfish you see are basically all the jellyfish that I have left. This con wiped me out. But that's a good thing. So I'm rambling. I'm very tired. The con went really well. Very excited to head home. We managed to get it all packed up into just 2 wagons. It's pretty friggin' awesome. And now we're heading home. Thank you, Katsucon. It's been awesome.